A child custody charge stemming from a bitter divorce. Now a former spokesperson for the St. Johns County Sheriff's Office is speaking out.
We're hearing directly from Sergeant Catherine Payne following an Amber Alert this week that triggered her arrest. We're also hearing from the attorney for her estranged husband, Philip. Channel 4's Kent Justice is joining us tonight with more on what both of them have to say, Kent.
Yeah, Catherine Payne sent a letter out today, and she admits that she has had a very difficult time here personally in the last couple of months. But she believes that she removed her child from his school on Tuesday with full legal authority. That is not what her estranged husband's attorney tells us happened.
Even though I was the public information officer for the St. Johns County Sheriff's Office, I wanted us to have a private life.
Sergeant Catherine Payne is on house arrest, facing a third-degree felony charge of interfering with child custody because of taking her own son Tuesday, allegedly planning to flee the state. At issue seems to be an order entered into court in St. Johns County, giving Payne's estranged husband full custody of the child after a series of psychiatric episodes involving the sergeant. A court order limiting custody and ordering supervised visits for Sergeant Payne dates to September 4th. She says she never saw it until after the Amber Alert Tuesday, when she had picked up her son and took him to dinner in Fernandina Beach.
You're absolutely sure you had the authority to do that at that point, is that right?
Correct. Had been in my attorney's office that morning and said if there was an issue, let me know.
She absolutely knew about that order, absolutely knew the terms of that order, and absolutely knew the conditions that she was under because of that order.
Brandon Beardsley is the lawyer for Payne's husband, and while they work out terms of their divorce, Beardsley says the intention has never been to strip custody from a loving mom. It's been to protect the six-year-old involved following a string of medical issues since August 28th for Catherine Payne, where the sergeant reportedly showed erratic behavior.
She's a great law enforcement officer. She's just had some health issues, we'll say, lately. When that happened, I had to protect the child. As Mr. Payne's attorney, I have to protect him. I protect his family.
Sergeant Payne says she only wanted some one-on-one time with her son and never intended to leave the state, as her husband's attorney suggests. Payne's grief at the entire situation seems evident, as does her heartbreak.
You know, Philip was the love of my life. It devastated me when we separated. But for this to happen has just been... I don't even know who that is, who that person is, and why he would do this.
What we're hearing from Sergeant Payne's estranged husband's attorney is that they kind of feel the same way. They went out of their way to say tonight how much they have respected Sergeant Payne as a law enforcement officer, how great a mother she has been in the past, but that they feel like recent medical issues have become an issue there. Sergeant Payne has been separated from her husband, a Florida State trooper, since July of last year.
So, Ken, do we know the status of Sergeant Payne's employment? Is she still with the St. Johns County Sheriff's Office?
Well, as we visited her with her tonight in her home, two things came out. She said that early this morning, 3 a.m., she had sent an email notification to the Sheriff's Office saying she was requesting a medical retirement based on some heart problems that have been discovered in the last couple of months. She also told us that today she received notice of suspension from the sheriff's office based on her felony arrest this week. But again, she doesn't plan on ever being back with the office that she spent 15 years of her life with.
Wow, that's a long time. All right. Thank you,
Kent.